I don't accept your apology, Gigabyte, although they're not really apologizing to me. What's going on here? Oh, I'm assuming if you clicked on this video or you found my channel, you're probably enough into the PC tech space and YouTube stuff related to that, that you're probably not only aware of the Gamers Nexus channel, which is fantastic, but also Tech Jesus's recent video, which I think I have above me right there, guys, about exploding power supplies from Gigabyte and Newegg. And this is somewhat related to something I ranted about recently, which is in Newegg Shuffle, although they occasionally toss in a few GPUs there that, you know, might be a reasonable deal, a lot of them, they bundle with crap you don't want. And it's one thing if it's crap you don't want that's actually good, but it's quite another thing if it's crap that you don't want that could actually damage your computer and literally isn't safe to use. Now, this video was following up on a whole bunch of user reports about this particular Gigabyte power supply. And don't worry, if you think this video is just me recapping the Gamers Nexus thing, no. This is me talking about a press release that Gigabyte just put out in response to this that I don't think is good enough. But anyway, it's this power supply, and I think also its 750-watt counterpart that is having the issues. You'll notice out of 92 Newegg reviews, this is only getting 3 out of 5 stars. And what Gamers Nexus was testing out was this people just mad about the Newegg Shuffle bundle thing? Or were these power supplies actual garbage? Because when you scroll through these reviews, let's pop over to the reviews here. You can see some people are like, hey, it's fine. I could shrink out of your way here. Some people are like, hey, it's fine, but there's a whole bunch of people who are like, don't install it in your PC, it doesn't work. Some people are like, dead on arrival. I think there were some here that are like, it fried my hard drive. There's a lot of fire hazard. You know, you don't want to put this in the system with the 3090 you just bought with it and have it fry your 3090. Could it really fry a GPU? Well, that's the kind of thing that Gamers Nexus was testing out. Do these power supplies actually break things? Well, he did have a Gigabyte RTX 3080, I believe it was, get fried during his testing. Now, theoretically, and he said this in the video, that could have been an unrelated issue to the power supply, but it's quite the coincidence. And I think 5 of the 10 units that they tested in the video didn't survive their testing, and this was all testing that a quality power supply unit should be able to survive. Anyway, here's Gigabyte's response to all of this. Well, first of all, you know, they take pride in the design and quality of their products. And hey, I'm gonna be honest, if I look over at my PC right now, I've got some Gigabyte parts in here, mainly because I'll generally just buy stuff that's cheap, although not power supplies. I will not skimp on the power supply. but anyway, so, I don't think I should just read through this entire thing, although I guess I could. There's some things here that stood out as bothering me. First of all, again, they're taking pride in the design and quality of their products, and so they take reports of this matter extremely seriously and therefore would like to address the reported potential issues as follows. So how are they addressing these horrible issues of all these power supplies that are dead on arrival, one possibly killed a GPU in the Gamers Nexus testing, so many Newegg reports of hard drives breaking, the power supplies just being dead on arrival, all sorts of issues. What do they think the issue is? Well, they think that their overpower protection safety feature, which is designed to shut down the unit when the power load exceeds the wattage of the unit was designed to operate within, well, they had it set to 120% to 150% of the power. And so basically, long story short, they've decided to dial that back by 10% or so that it'll trip earlier, rather than letting it get pushed quite so hard before it gets there. So that's their giant response to all of this. They are going to slightly adjust to lower the OPP settings on these two power supplies. They are not recalling the units. They're not changing any of the components in the units. They are slightly tuning the overpower protection. Slightly. Just so it trips a little bit earlier. That's it. That's all they're doing. Although I think they are, let's read a little bit farther here. So that's all they're offering. So GIGABYTE highly values the confidence and trust all our customers have in our product quality and after-sale services. GIGABYTE would like to stress the potential issues that were reported only seemed to occur after very long time periods of extreme load testing via DC electronic load equipment that would not be typical of any real-world usage. In other words, they don't like that Gamers Nexus used the proper equipment to do this with, by the way, equipment all to put these through extreme loads. They're like, well, that's not typical use. It's like, and these issues were only ever occurring due to this unrealistic use case. Well, keep in mind that Gamers Nexus was testing this not for funsies. They were testing this because they were asked to, because their viewers were reporting on these issues. These reviews on Newegg, by the way, are many of them from well before the date of the Gamers Nexus video. This one is from January. This one is from, you know, back in, I mean, this one says it's decent, but that's from back in November. Caused my system randomly restart. That's back in February. Dead on arrival, that's back in January. Do not install in PC, back in January. The point is that these issues were being widely reported in all of these negative reviews way before this video came out a few days ago. This video took a long time of testing for Gamers Nexus to make. They've been doing it for a long time because these issues have been reported for a long time. So all GIGABYTE is really saying here is that Steve over at Gamers Nexus was mean and started picking on our power supplies by running it through all of this like overcurrent protection tripping stuff that would never happen in a real PC. And if he hadn't done that, everything was fine. But we'll slightly down-tune stuff so it looks like we're doing something and say that, you know, we highly value the confidence and trust of all of our customers have in our stuff here. Now, with all of that being said, they are saying that to offer customers complete peace of mind, any serial number not listed in Appendix 1 are the amended OPP settings as listed in Point 3. So basically they're saying that you can look at the serial numbers to figure out if you have one of the amended units, the ones where they slightly down-tuned the trigger point. Okay, so you can at least tell which one you have based on the serial number. It says that despite the fact that both before and after, OPP adjustment versions are reliable for real-world usage, we still offer owners of these two models of products included in the serial number range listed in Appendix 1 can apply for the blah, 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 model numbers return and exchange service. So they are offering returns and exchanges through this press release here, but I hate the wording of this press release. They're basically, and they say stuff like that I read there a couple times, once at the beginning and once at the end, that they're just acting like this is some big thing that just happened because of Gamers Nexus testing and the way they did that in these unrealistic situations. They're not acknowledging that people were having all of these issues beforehand, and that's why it was being tested out in the first place. So, I think GIGABYTE, you need to do better with your press release. And I think you should just admit there's a problem with the units and probably just offer a recall. But hey, that might be asking way too much from a company to, you know, recall a product that is clearly defective. Anyway, what do you guys think about all this? If you stuck around till the end, thank you. And I hope that you have an excellent day.